Montgomery County District Attorney Kevin R. Steele and Paxman Police Chief Mick Maverick announced the arrest of Avery Nascimento, 21 of Pottsville, for the murder of 36-year-old Sean Robbins early Sunday morning. At 2:41 a.m. Sunday, January 23, 2022, Pottstown Police responded to the 100 block of Sheridan Street in Pottstown for a report of gunshots fired. Arriving officers found 34-year-old Sedonia Medonic outside of her residence suffering from multiple gunshot wounds. Inside the residence, officer found Robbins, who was deceased from a gunshot wound to the head. Medonic was transported to Reading Hospital for treatment and is expected to survive. A joint investigation by the Montgomery County Detective Bureau and Pottstown Police found that Medonic was in a romantic relationship with the defendant, who had been at her residence to hang out. An argument had ensued over photos in Medonic's cell phone. Nascimento struck Medonic, choked her, threatened her with a handgun, and told her she was going to die tonight. After learning of the assault, Robbins, Medonic's ex-boyfriend, arrived at the residence. The victim and defendant attempted to talk it out, but became involved in a physical altercation that ended with Robbins being shot. As Medonic ran from the residence, she was shot multiple times by the defendant, falling on a neighbor's porch where she played dead. Nascimento then fled. Detectives also learned that Medonic had a protection from abuse order against Nascimento. My heartfelt condolences go out to the family and friends of the victim, who is trying to help his friend, said Steele. This is yet another Montgomery County homicide related to domestic violence or relationship homicide. Please, if you're living in a violent situation at home or in a violent relationship, call for help. The Laurel House 24/7 hotline is 800-642-3150, and the Women's Center of Montgomery County hotline is 800-773-2424. An autopsy on Robbins' body was performed by Dr. Khalil Wardrick of the Montgomery County Coroner's Office, which found that the cause of death was a gunshot to the head and the manner of the death was homicide. Nascimento is charged with first-degree murder, attempted murder, aggravated assault, strangulation, terroristic threats, recklessly endangering another person, and related offenses. He was also arraigned today before Magistrate District Judge Edward Crope Sr. There is no bail available for first-degree murder, and he was remanded to the Montgomery County Correctional Facility. Preliminary hearing is scheduled for 8 a.m. February 2, 2022 before Judge Crope. All criminal charges and any discussion thereof are merely allegations, and all defendants are presumed innocent until and unless proven guilty. What's up, fam? So as y'all can see, this is a very tragic situation. I would love to show a news clip, but of course, you know, YouTube is really extra about us using other people's material. They like to demonetize things, so I'm just going to leave the news clip to the bottom. Also, I'm going to leave the article to the bottom in the comment section if you would like to look further into this very tragic, unfortunate situation. So it just sounds like to me, basically, the victim, the woman in the situation, her and the defendant, the one who's being charged with the actual death of the other young man, seems like to me, her and the young man was trying to at least reconcile or work out their differences. Yeah, Nascimento, this is the name of the young man who's actually, of course, you know, innocent until proven guilty, but we can pretty much already figure out the consequence of this. But sounds like to me, Nascimento, the murderer, and so allegedly the murderer, and Medonic, the woman, that's the middle person in the situation, just sounds like to me, him and her was at her residence and they were probably hashing things out. They were probably considering reconciling or working on their relationship, which really he wasn't supposed to be over there. She already had a restraining order out. So for her to have to put a restraining order out on him, 9 times out of 10, there was already some prior issues. Either he physically assaulted her before, or she felt like her safety was in jeopardy, which is why she felt like she had to go get a restraining order. So the fact that she had a restraining order to begin with, And now Cemento, this young man who was over there, and he was not supposed to be, that's already one problem within itself. Because again, she had to get a restraining order out on him. So why would she go against the restraining order that she placed out on him? I'm not too certain of that, but women do it a lot. Women get into a physical dispute, or a man, boyfriend gets mad, makes threats, I'm gonna whip your ass, I'm gonna kill you next time I see you, whatever. You know, couples argue, they fight, things go left, and she probably saw some red flags, like, nah, let me put a restraining order on him. But nevertheless, women do it all the time. They break restraining orders. You know, man call back, start talking good, get in her ear, you know, start, you know, talking that good talk, that smooth, slick game, that WD-40 game, you know, baby, I'm sorry, I was wrong, you know, I just really love you, you know what I'm saying, I'm just a jealous man because, you know, I know you're a beautiful woman, and I don't like all kind of dudes around you and giving you too much attention, you know what I'm saying, so he probably did some good talk, and they were supposedly trying to work it out, and he looked through her phone, and look and behold, he's seen something totally different from, I guess, what they were discussing. Now, I will say this. There's a couple of elements to this. Because with situations like this, we automatically want to side with the woman. We automatically want to side with the victim. Especially when a life has been involved. You know, the person who actually did the murder or the killing, we most of the time don't show no empathy. We don't sympathize with them, and it's not that we should, but at the same token, you have to be mindful with how you mislead people, making them think that it's just going to only be them, or it was never nobody else, it was just them. You have some people out here that are very weak. You got these men, and you got some women out here that are very weak. They can't handle being played, being manipulated, being lied to, being deceived. And the moment they find out you don't cross them, or you made them believe that y'all was going to have something, and all this time they finding out you've been already dealing with somebody, or you was reconsidering going back to someone else. You know, some people become unhinged. They see black. They just ready to attack. They become instantly aggressive. They don't ask no questions. They just lose it. They jump off the deep end. So emotions are very deadly right now. You really have to be very careful with how you play with people's emotions. So it sounds like to me, him and her was hashing some things out, or just talking, or whatever the case was. Things went left, whatever the case. And that is when the ex-boyfriend, he came over there, you know, on the strength of looking out for his ex-girlfriend. You know, evidently he probably still had feelings for her, or he cared about her. He knew she was in danger, and he could have easily not gotten involved. He could have easily just disregarded it and say, you know what, F that, that's their problem, I got nothing to do with it. But whatever the case was, he cared enough about her to come over there and get involved. And things went totally left. You know, as the article said, you know, the victim and the defendant, they were attempting to talk it out, but became involved in a physical altercation. And of course, Robbins, you know, that is the young man, Sean Robbins, who got killed in the process of going over there to see about his ex-female companion. You know, evidently he cared about her, you know, and it's easy for other people to be on somewhere. You know, he should have stayed out of that. He shouldn't have got involved in that. You know, when you care about somebody, that was just a man in him, that was just a friend in him. And unfortunately, in this case, it cost him his life. It took him his life, and you can tell both families are really grieving over this situation. You have three families that are affected by this. I have gone on the Facebook pages of all these individuals, you know, the killer, you know, his family is very devastated because they're basically insinuating he's never been one to murder or kill. He this first time in this situation. So they're empathizing, you know, with Mr. Avery Nascimento. You know, that is the one who actually killed the other young man, Sean Robbins. His family's empathizing with him. You know, like, this ain't like you. You know, he's never been one to do anything like this before. You know, they're just as blindsided by his actions as he probably was. You know, sometimes you don't know how capable you are of really hurting somebody till you get in a situation. Everybody's not born murderers or born killers. Unfortunately, if you're the type of man or woman, you don't have any control over your you don't have any discipline over your emotions, or somebody betrays you or plays you, and you don't find a way to try to just accept that L. Hair is every woman's clown in glory. So women have invested in hundreds all over the world trying to find the perfect hair oil to suit their needs. There are so many types of hair oils in the beauty supply industry that it makes it pretty difficult to choose which hair oil is right for you. Well, look no further. Rejuvenate is here. Some of these oils are watered down with other oils such as canola oil and soybean oil, which takes away the purity of the natural oils. Many hair oil companies do this so they can stretch the product of the oil to fit more in the bottle, making it appear as if you are getting a lot for your money's worth, but you are actually getting more artificial oil. So beware of oils that don't say 100% oil in the ingredients. Rejuvenate does exactly what it means. It rejuvenates the roots, revitalizing dead hair follicles, bringing roots back to life. Many women are suffering from alopecia, and others are experiencing breakage that's causing excessive shedding. Unlike most hair oils that usually only consist of four or less types of oils, each bottle of Rejuvenate consists of 18 herbs. No artificial oils have been added to stretch the product. Some of these oils include black rice oil, red pimento, mango seed, papaya, rosemary, hemp seed, sweet almond oil, black castor oil, aloe vera, peppermint, lavender, avocado oil, nettle extract, ginkgo extract, clove hair oil, flaxseed oil, shea butter, and so much more. Yes, these 2-ounce bottles have 18 different herbs, all 100% oils. Each purchase will come with a mini pamphlet explaining the purpose of each unique herb. All other herbs are special ingredients and cannot be disclosed for copyright purposes. Keep in mind that some of you may have certain things that you may be allergic to that your scalp may not necessarily agree with, which may cause an allergic reaction. So please consult with your physician before utilizing the product, and I further recommend a skin patch test before applying oil throughout the entire scalp or skin. This oil can be used as a hot oil treatment or for everyday use. Oil should not have to be applied no more than 2 to 3 times per week. Men that are also experiencing hair loss or hair breakage can also benefit from Rejuvenate's hair follicle stimulator oil. Each batch of oil takes up to 3 weeks to ferment before it is actually shipped off to customers. Rejuvenate is $8 per bottle, or you can purchase up to 2 bottles for up to 14. This is a limited time offer, so you will get $2 off purchasing 2 bottles. This does not include shipping and handling fees. You have up to 5 days to return product and up to 15 days to request refund in the event there's an issue with the product on the order. Unlike other oils, Rejuvenate is homemade. I specifically take my time and prepare each batch custom made before shipping to customers. Order your bottle of Rejuvenate so you can bring your roots back to life. All information of where to purchase will be included below. Thank you for your support. And keep it moving. You mentally allow it to eat you up like cancer, to the point to where you feel like you have to do something. You got to show this person that they crossed the wrong one. So of course his family, they're posting, you know, free my dog, and you know, keep your head up, you know, not having any empathy, you know, for the victims in this situation, you know. So again, his family, Nascimento's family, is definitely in a culture shock, because I guess, you know, he doesn't have a reputation, as far as I know, being the type of guy to do this. Then there's Sean Robbins, of course, whose family is very distraught because he lost his life trying to do a good deed. He got involved in somebody else's turmoil, and just being a friend, you know, he was being a friend. He was very concerned, you know, about the young lady's safety that was involved. So He went over there and he was gunned down in a senseless dispute. And the sad part about it is he is a father of three children. And, you know, his family, his mother, his mother's going to be without a son. His children are going to be without a father. And it's very unfortunate because he was trying to do the right thing. And sometimes, you know, you can be the type of person who can do the right thing and have a heart. And doing the right thing and having a heart, unfortunately, has caused some people to lose their lives. It's just a chance that you take. So I can't really judge this young man and say he was wrong for going over there. He should have never got involved, because who's to say if that young lady would have died, or if, you know, Nascimento would have killed, you know, Masinka, whatever, and she would have died, and him knowing what was going on, he didn't go over there to intervene. That would have been on his conscience. So I can't necessarily, you know, say he was wrong or right as far as getting involved. That was a protocol he made because he felt just that strongly about Masinta, you know, Masinta, whose life was in danger at the time. So he went over there, you know, being a friend. Madonic, yeah, that's her name. She has a very unusual name, but Madonic. Yep, so, you know, he went over there to look out for Madonic, and this is what happened. So I basically say all that to really say this, is that you just have situations of which some people just have no control over their emotions. They just don't. I'm not sure the exact role Madonic played. I don't know if she made Nascimento believe that she wanted to be with him, that somehow, some way they were going to end up together, they was going to work things out. I'm not sure what she led him on to believe, what was the incentive. My other main concern is, why was he over there when there was a restraining order in place? Did she welcomingly allowed him to come over? Sounds like, based on the article, but you know, sometimes these news outlets, they tend to embellish or they twist the story. It sounded as if she granted him access, like they were trying to work some things out, if that was really the case. Or did he just bombard and went over there on his own free will to try to plead with her to, you know, work things out? That part I'm still kind of vague on. But if she willingly allowed him over there, I would say this. That's going to be on her conscience for the rest of her life, because you have to look at the fact, you, as a woman, you didn't trust this man, which is why you went and got a restraining order. And the fact that you violated it and you allowed him to come over there, and this man tried to kill you once he looked through your phone and he saw something. Something made him jump over the deep end. How the hell he got a hold of your phone? What made him even look through your phone? Evidently, he didn't take your word and felt the need to look through your phone. And he saw something that triggered him. Now, I'm not saying that what triggered him is justified in him killing anybody. But you have to realize, you have some people that are emotionally weak. And even more so, you have men these days just as weak as the women they complain about. You have a lot of these men, these young men, you know, who just don't know how to accept an L. They don't know how to just take an L. You know, if you find out a woman playing you, or she's deceiving you, and instead of you, you know, taking the L and saying, you know what, I see this broad does not have my best interest, she's using me, she's playing me, you know what, I'm done with her. I'm going to move on, better myself, and get somebody better. Get a woman I know who's going to do right by me. Get a woman I know who's going to be trustworthy. No, you have these young men now, they just taking women out. They're just taking them out. They murdering them. They killing them. Are they physically attacking them? You just have some men that's not man enough to take an L. It's like you got some women that aren't women enough to take an L. Like I said, I don't know what he was over there for. But it's unfortunate that three lives are ruined because this man is going to end up in prison for the rest of his life. Now, Cemento is going to end up in prison. He's only 21 years old. His life is over. Certain decisions you make, there are no do-overs. And I'm a living witness. One bad decision could change the whole dynamics of your life. It could change your well-being. It can change your livelihood. It could change your freedom. And the bad part is it could affect everybody else, people who love you and care about you, who had absolutely nothing to do with your bad decision. It impacts the children involved. It impacts the parents. It impacts so many people other than just you. Mr. Nascimento, he really did not think this all the way through. And I'm sure if Mr. Robbins came over there, whatever it was, whatever exchange of words they had concerning the female Madonna, it should have not had to resort to him shooting Mr. Robbins in his head. I'm sure whatever it was, whatever physical altercation, a physical dispute, unless Mr. Robbins pulled out a gun and tried to kill him first, which we know that's not the case because it's nowhere in the details that warranted for self-defense. And it's so many young men that are incarcerated over two things, emotions and ego. Ego-emotional. That's why I do a lot of my series when I talk about these type of situations. Ego-emotional dudes. You're full of ego and emotion. Your emotions made you get beside yourself. And these same dudes that go around here, you know, stressing the alpha males, the alpha, you know, they're masculine. Be the main ones when they get in situations like this, you know, all the lack of masculinity. All the masculinity runs out. It runs out the door. It doesn't. It just totally runs out the door. All of this over a woman, and it's not to say that, you know, she doesn't have any significance. But at the same time, his self-esteem was so low, he couldn't handle the betrayal, the rejection. Whatever it was that triggered him or provoked him, it caused him to kill this man who had nothing to really do, really. He just came over there to see about her. And he took it out on him. When really, that was not the main person that he was angry with. He was really angry with the woman. But what happened was his emotions got the best of him. It didn't matter who came over there that night. They was going to get killed. If the young lady, if her mother, her brother, her cousin, it didn't matter who came, he was going to kill somebody that night. The dude was ego-emotional. He was emotional because he found something in the phone that triggered him. It pissed him off. He couldn't handle it. He lost it. Tried to kill her, and then on top of that, killed her friend to see about her. So it didn't matter who was there. They was going to get killed. Just so if it happened, this man who's a father of three, who's a coach, I think of a basketball or football team. I know he's an athletic coach. Another black man that was about something. Like, as I say all the time, the biggest threat of black men are other black men. It's not so much black women. Black men's biggest threat is other black men. A black man will kill another black man, no questions asked. That black man has something he wants or has something he feel like he's the only one that should be entitled to get, he's going to take that brother out by any means necessary. He's going to bang, bang, bang and ask questions later. And in most cases, don't ask questions at all. Then he could have killed her. Had she not played dead, he could have killed her. He really could have took both of them. Both of them could have been gone and to meet their maker. She had to play dead, and she lucky he didn't go back to make sure he finished the job off. But it's sad because that's going to be her conscience. She's going to have to live with that. She's going to, unfortunately, be in a position where she's going to always have to take that blame. The victim, the young man who was killed, Mr. Robbins, his family are going, his family is going to feel some type of way. Because, you know, when in situations like this, people are always looking to blame someone. And in many cases, someone is usually to blame. But truth be told, it's kind of not her fault, you know, that this young man got killed. Because you cannot predict the psyche of these people. I don't think she knew Mr. Robbins would have got killed coming over there to defend her. I don't think she knew that. I don't think she saw that coming. Hell, Mr. Robbins, I don't think he saw that coming. Probably think, I'm just going to go over there, see what's going on, make sure things don't get out of hand. He's not looking for anything else worse or more severe to come out of it. He probably thought it was going to be a simple dispute. He go over there, hash it out, whatever, and he get to go back home to his children. It went totally different. And I realized when it comes to domestic disputes, you're really taking a chance getting involved. As much as, you know, especially when it's involving somebody you love, you care about, you really take a chance when you get involved. Even being a law enforcement, they tell you most law enforcement officers get killed, lose their lives responding to domestic violent calls. Most officers are killed responding to domestic disputes, domestic violent calls, in most cases. Because you have to realize when you're involved in those type of situations, a lot of emotions are on 1,000. Emotions on 1,000. People aren't thinking straight. They're allowing their anger to get the best of them. Emotions are at an all-time high during a domestic dispute. Especially the one that's the aggressor. The aggressor, in many cases, they lose their cool 100%. Anybody who gets involved when they are already on emotional all-time high and somebody steps on the scene, anybody can get it. Anytime you approach a domestic violence situation and you have to approach the aggressor, just like this young man did, he approached the aggressor. The victim who died trying to help the woman, Madonna, trying to beat up for her, he got killed in the process because Nascimento was already on an emotional high. He was so angry that there was no reasoning with him. There was no trying to reach an understanding. He totally lost his cool. He killed that man. When you're walking into a domestic violence situation, it's almost like you walking into a burning house. You're walking into a raging fire. And if you're not careful, you can get burned. You can get burned. And that's what happened. You know, Robbins tried to do the right thing. He tried to be there for this woman. He heard she was in trouble. This woman has kids, and he's a father. He has children. He probably went over there out of concern for her and her children. They don't want the children hurt. Probably thought he can go over there and talk this man down and try to hash things out. And this dude was already on 1,000. And that's the chance you take, unfortunately, whenever you approach a domestic violence situation. You know, you're going into a situation that's very hostile because you're dealing with individuals that are very aggressive and they're not thinking straight. And I'm sure right now that young man, now that he has calmed down, he's in jail, I'm sure reality is sinking in. If he's not regretting it now, he's damn sure going to regret it later and realize, you know what, all of that didn't warrant for that. It happens. We all are human beings. I've been in situations where, you know, I have boyfriends, you know, before I got married, caught them deceiving me, finding stuff in their phone, finding text messages. You know, we didn't have social media back then. We ain't had no Facebook. But we had, you know, little flip phones and stuff, or if not that, you just found out through word of street, hey, you know, so-and-so, your boyfriend talking to this girl, and, you know, this and that, I ran into them at the movies, you know, this and that, you know, things wasn't publicized as it is today, but the emotions were all the same. And all of us have experienced some level of heartbreak and betrayal. All of us have experienced getting dead in. It has happened to all of us. But you got to get a grip. You got to get a grip on it. You can't allow situations like this to make you lose your cool. You become way in over your head. You react before thinking. You jump to conclusions. Anybody who intervenes in a situation, you're willing to lash out and hurt them because you're so angry and pissed off about how you feel betrayed or you feel deceived. You really, really, in these type of situations like this, you really have to step back and evaluate before you do something that you're going to regret, before you make a decision that you're stuck with for a lifetime. But my heart definitely goes out to this family. Situations like this happen a lot. Happens a lot. It just sounds like to me, him and her has something going on. And, you know, she went back on homeward, allowed this man to come over, knowing that he already had some type of aggression. Because, again, she put a restraining order out on him. For what? Why? That was already a red flag. And she allowed him in her personal domain, in her personal residence. All bets are off when you let a man who you had to file a restraining order out on, you allow him to have access to your home, to your house. There's no one there to protect you. In an event this dude loses it, he snaps, then your children are there. Like I said, a lot of these, you know, violent guys, they are good charmers. They know how to talk a good game. You know, I just want to see you. You know, I'm not coming over there to turn up. You know, I'm not coming to see you to make no trouble. I just really want to see you. I just want to talk to you. I just want to see if we can work things out. I just want to see if we can see what possibilities we have to reconcile. You know, these guys, they know how to talk smooth like butter. You know, get you comfortable, cause you to let your guard down. He doing that sweet baby, I'm sorry, I apologize, I know I was wrong. You go against your better judgment, you let him over there. Especially if you still know you got unresolved issues, you still see other dudes, you still talking to somebody, you still got other relationships going on, he'd look through your phone, see text messages that you still texting dudes, or finding pictures that you booed up with some other dudes while you making him believe it's just gonna be you and him that you done. You don't want nobody else. You just want to be with him. You want to work the relationship out with him. He goes through your phone and see otherwise. He's triggered. And one thing about it, an emotional man is more dangerous than an emotional woman. When women get emotional, we'll cry, we'll cuss, act a fool, we may even bust a window. But an emotional man will kill. And in this case, that's what makes men more dangerous than women. When a man get emotional, it's dangerous. Because he going all out. Because men rarely get emotional. So when they do get emotional, that's like a goddamn hurricane. That's a Hurricane Matthew situation. No, Hurricane Katrina situation. He tearing up every goddamn thing. And he don't care who get caught up. It's a very unfortunate situation. My heart definitely goes out to the Madonic family. My heart goes out to the Nascimento family. And my heart definitely goes out to the Robbins family. Because all of these people, their lives are changed forever over a moment, over a dispute, disagreement. It's over. This young man, his troubles are just beginning. He's already in jail. He's going to have to face trial, face the judge, relive this nightmare that he done created. And get shipped off to prison. And he's going to end up without this woman in his life anyway. That's what a lot of people don't understand. You want so badly to be with somebody. You don't mind going to prison. You don't mind taking their life. But guess what? That just means you still not going to get the person you want. Because you're going to prison. So he wasn't going to be with her anyway. I'm sure he knows that now. But anyway, y'all, leave your comment below. Let me know what y'all think about this situation here. It's a very tragic, unfortunate situation. Again, you know, my heart definitely goes out to the victims in this case. My heart definitely goes out to the families that have been impacted by this. You know, it's a very unfortunate situation. Please make sure y'all hit that like button, thumb this up. Please share the video. It's plenty of young women that are in domestic violence situations. Please share this video. Let them know that if they are in a situation in which they are with the man that is very aggressive, he's overly emotional, he has no control over his emotions, he's already violent, he has already physically put his hands on her at some point in time, he has threatened her at some point in time where she had to resort to getting a restraining order, please let her be aware that situations like this can always escalate if you keep entertaining it. Once a person that shows you their left hand, you don't sit around and wait to see their right hand. And same thing for men. If you are with a female that has shown you any violent tendencies, she's shown you that she will put her hands on you. She has no respect for you as a man. Get out of Dodge. Get out of that situation as quick as possible. Once a person has already threatened you or put their hands on you, this is not the time to let your ego get in the way, let your pride get in the way. You're going to stand by them no matter what, because sooner than later, the disrespect is going to keep escalating, and it's going to lead to these type of situations here. So do not play with your livelihood. Do not play with your safety. So anyway, y'all be blessed. I'm supposed to be going live tonight with Ray, with Cool Gent. I'm going to have some guys on my panel. We're going to chop it up. We're going to talk about different things within the black sector of the YouTube streets. You know, we got a lot of things we're going to be talking about. We're going to be chopping it up. So y'all make sure y'all tune in later. I believe I'm probably going to do my live stream panel probably about 8 o'clock, between 8:30. So please make sure y'all tune in. Be glad when I see y'all there. Y'all be blessed. Remember, this is your deep in knowledge. Remember, I'm going to always break you off a slice of knowledge, and I'm always pour you a cup of truth. Y'all be blessed. Take care.